All right, moving on. The last laugh.
This one. Oh my.
This one is epic.
This is epic. This is one that I can remember. So, like, just my dad and I, this is the one thing that we could kind of get along. Like I said, the season tickets I had since the 80s when I go to games with my dad. And I remember watching this one at home because obviously they're at Kansas City. And it just,
oh, it's so good.
Without giving away too much, this was just like, I've never seen my dad more exuberant with joy than this moment.
Same thing with my mom, man. Same thing exactly with my mom. She probably scared the poor animals that were running. but just like we were talking before about not giving up. And in sports, don't ever give up. And it couldn't have been displayed any better than within this game. The date was November 11th, 1990. It was week 10 versus the Kansas City Chiefs at Arrowhead Stadium. The sun was shining. It was clear, 63-degree day. The stands were packed. You could just see that red sea of fans. 71,000 fans in attendance. And our quarterback for this game was the one and only Dave Craig. And this game is definitely legendary, but it's not legendary for what the Seahawks did, which it should be, but it's not. It's actually known for what one man did on the field, which is, to this day, pretty mind-blowing.
Yeah. The one-man wrecking crew that was Derek Thomas sacking Dave Craig. Seven times.
Seven
times. Which was a new NFL times. Record for most sacks in a single contest.
It was insane. I mean, just watching the highlights of this, you're just watching it going, oh my God, he looks like, remember we used to play Tecmo Bowl? And
yeah.
you could run around the guys and it looks like that fast, like how fast he was during that.
It looked like Tecmo Bowl.
It was crazy. He couldn't be stopped. He could not be stopped.
To be honest, even before the play we're obviously alluding to, Dave Craig probably could have easily been sacked like four or five more times that game by him. Like there was so many times where like, I'm wondering like, is anyone on earth blocking? And why are we sending anybody out or out at this point? Like, what are we doing? Like,
oh, it's insane.
It's so frustrating at home to watch. Like we were just getting destroyed.
It's completely insane. And again, like these damn Seahawks games, it comes down to the very end. It's the fourth quarter and the Seahawks are down with 4 seconds remaining. The Hawks need just a touchdown to win this game. The ball is snapped. And Dave Craig...
damn near gets killed again.
He looks like he's about to get sacked again by Derek Thomas.
He like literally sneaks right out of his arms, I believe.
It's crazy. He somehow manages to avoid Thomas and getting sacked for the 8th time. And he throws this bullet strike right into the end zone to Paul Scansey for the tie. Are you kidding me? First off, how did he escape that? Secondly, what a throw!
Well, it's crazy too, if you watch it, Scansey's like open, or like, I'm like, throw the ball! Like, he's so open the side, which
he's
is
wide
incredible.
Open, right in the middle.
And then it's like, but Craig doesn't see it, and so he waits until he's actually ran back into some sort of coverage, so by the time the ball's released, you're like, oh, this isn't going to be good.
But
damn
Ethan,
it, we missed our window of opportunity.
But Ethan, he has other things on his mind, like running for his life.
Yeah. Well, no question, and to be all fair, he's been doing it all day long, too.
He's quite exhausted.
His, like, life.
He's exhausted. Yeah,
well,
so
Scansey, who was like the working class here, I mean, just another one of those receivers he had to love. He was like the poor man's Largen.
Right.
Know, he's like, got things.
Total workhorse, yeah. Totally.
Yep.
Yeah, so, and just like you were watching with your dad, I was watching with my mom, and we were in the living room, and she screamed so loud that our next-door neighbors, they probably thought there was a murder going on or something. I mean, like, I remember jumping up so high in the air that my knuckles, like, the old popcorn.
The ceiling. Yeah.
I had blood coming down my hands, and I was like, didn't care. This is amazing. And we ended up winning that game, by the way.
Yeah, well, Norm Johnson, your favorite, comes out and kicks the game-winning extra point. That was a little nerve-wracking.
Yeah, Norm for the win. Yes. So, yeah, when I finally had the chance to meet up with Dave Craig, I made sure to personally thank him for that game specifically because it was one of the greatest games that I've ever seen as a Seahawks fan. And, you know, talking about not giving up, man, that is a perfect example of never giving up because, dude, at that point in time, it's easy to give up. I mean, I'm sorry. Like, he was being abused in that game.
Yeah.
Abused. So the fact that he was able to come back and throw essentially the winning touchdown in that game is nuts. completely insane. So, Dave Craig, you may have been sacked 7 times in that game for an NFL record, but you, my friend, you had the last laugh. Ha 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 ha